Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome to the vlog. Today is February 6th, it's Tuesday, and it's kind of a hard day for me, and my dog, my oldest dog, he's 15 years old, we had to put him down today. So, you know, he was old and he lived a really good life, and he was the best dog ever because I trained him. It was just time, you know, he had a lot of health issues, so we kind of decided as a family that it would be best just to, you know, stop the pain and put him to sleep. And that's really hard, you know, to have to let go of him, but I'm happy that he won't be in pain anymore, and I definitely have cried it out. I'm here in New York, but my parents and my dogs are in Pittsburgh, so I got to FaceTime with him, and I talked to him today on the phone before he went in, but it's hard. It's just hard. And, you know, I figured why not just, like, show this part. Like, sorry to start this vlog on such a low note, but it's just real life, and I keep thinking, like, I'm really looking forward to going to the gym today. I'm gonna go with Alexis after she's done with work. And really just zone out at the gym. Like, the gym for me has been a meditative experience over the last couple years, and like it's a great way to relieve stress and anger and any emotion you're going through, so I think it'll be really good for me. Hopefully you too can see the benefits of going to the gym, not just for, you know, physical reasons, but also mentally. It is like really the best place to work out your emotions, you know, and just kind of turn off your brain for a little bit and just focus and do something that's beneficial for your health and your mind and your spirit. So that's what I'm gonna do today. On that note, thanks for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up and enjoy. I'm gonna take you through my week. We're gonna go work out in a little bit, and it's all gonna be good. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next clip. Mama, come here. I'm alone, 'cause this house don't feel like home. If you love me, don't let go. Whoa. If you love me, don't let go. Oh, hold on, hold up to me, 'cause I'm a little unsteady. This is an experiment. So I really want you to observe and take note of your eating habits, your behaviors. You know, if by the end of the day you've eaten only like, you know, 2,000 calories and you're stuffed and you can't even eat anymore, then maybe we'll adjust the numbers, you know? It's part science, but also part guesstimation, and you get to play within these numbers. So you also might learn that, wow, you know what, I actually eat a ton of protein already in my diet, but what I don't get enough of is carbohydrates, or vice versa. You know, these are the things you're gonna learn, so really take note of that. Yeah, so that's your nutrition plan there. I gave you a kind of a little sample meal plan, like you see there, so feel free to get creative, but those are some of my go-to favorite meals. Cool, any other questions on that part? Hey guys, what's up? It is now February 13th, Tuesday. It has been exactly a week since I picked up this camera to vlog. And I started off this video with a pretty depressing note. Well, I did want to just say thanks to everybody for all of the kind words and the messages. It really does mean so much to me. You know, losing a furry friend is never an easy thing to go through. You know, you expect that it's gonna happen, but it's still tough. And I made a post about this on Instagram, but like really one of the things that really helped me through that day was going to the gym. And I know it's crazy, but the gym is not just good for your body, it's good for your mind, your spirit, your soul. Like literally just having something else to focus on just for, you know, an hour kind of takes your mind off of things and it relieves mental stress. And that's so important. It's so needed, especially during tough times. So I'm happy that I stuck with my workouts, even though, you know, it's really easy just to kind of give up and lay in bed and, you know, forget about the day. I'm glad I pushed myself just to get back out and get back to my workout. So right now I am just finishing a back workout. I just did that and I came back home and I'm eating some Cheerios. Yes, Cheerios. This has kind of been my go-to carb source recently because I don't normally eat a lot of cereal, but I'm just craving it. So one of my friends was asking me like, is it okay? Like, what's a good breakfast to have? Is breakfast cereal really bad for you? Because that's what he thought. Breakfast cereal is really bad. That's, I mean, kind of true. Like, yes, there's a lot of breakfast cereals out there that are just packed with sugar and, you know, junk, really. Like, bad ingredients, you know, like the marshmallows aren't always made out of the best things and Lucky Charms. So you need to be aware of, like, what you're eating, and you do want, if you're gonna have a breakfast, you want that meal to be a good, well-balanced meal. But should you be afraid of cereal? Not necessarily. I have just been craving Cheerios, and I rarely buy the box, the big box from Costco, but I did last time, and it's a really easy way to get in carb source. The thing is, whatever your goals are, you know, as long as a food fits in your macronutrients, when you're following that flexible dieting lifestyle, as long as a food fits in your macros, it's okay to eat. So this is about like 3 cups of Cheerios here. 1 cup is, I think, 19 grams of carbs. So basically like a ton of carbs right there. And it's not the best source of carbs, no. Sweet potatoes, brown rice, they're probably a better option. But for right now, it fits in my macros and it's okay for me to eat. All right, enough of that rant. I'll check in with you guys a little bit later on. Check out my new setup, guys. I have moved my computer out here into the living room area. This is normally where Alexis works because she works from home, but she moved into the bedroom where I used to have all my stuff, which makes a lot more sense because she can shut the door and it can be quiet since she's on phone calls all day. And I'll be out here. Now I have access to the living room, to the kitchen, to the door, to the bathroom. So we're gonna try this out and see how it goes. But I'm excited for a change of scenery. Sometimes it's nice, you know, especially when you're like working from home and I have a lot of client calls throughout the day and I'm getting tired of just pacing around my bedroom. At least now I have more space to do that. This is how you make a one bedroom apartment in New York City where both of you work from home. This is how you make that work. Gotta be flexible and gotta rearrange things often until you find something that works. So I'm actually gonna wrap up the vlog right here. I really appreciate you guys watching. I really appreciate you just hanging out with me and subscribing to this channel. Give this video a thumbs up because it really helps me out. And I always hope that you can learn something. That's the whole point of this vlog, you know, share some of my experiences. So appreciate you guys. I'll see you in the next video. Stay tuned. I have more coming. Talk to you guys later. Bye.